road claws my ass. No whistling again. So all it is, a bit of a water leak. Bit breezy, as you can see. I'll just give it a quick wash. I'll tackle all that fork leg corrosion later when it's properly warm. And as I said before, it's only superficial, soon come off. I just took that other thermometer on the Fahrenheit one. Well, it's switchable Fahrenheit or centigrade. Sticky pad with Velcro on. Velcro fluff onto the clock middle section. And on the back of here is a little spiky hooks, so it's removable, you know, so it won't get pinched. It's only £10 anyway, but it's the sort of thing that'll get nicked. I should have put some new sticky foam on that. That's coming a bit loose after 2 years. It doesn't last forever, that sticky foam. So, nice day. The world's my lobster. I thought of going to Dunsop Bridge, that nice little route, and see if the road's open there. Is it been improved any? Have they built that bloody wall up? It was closed for ages because of a dry stone wall that had fell over in the storms. Why take so long mending something so trivial? It's not that much of a night that it can't be done in a couple of weekends' work, surely. A roller coaster road with a nasty dip in the middle. Oh, fucking hell, fire. I thought I'd steer for the middle because it might be less severe, but it's just as bad, if not worse. I'm amazed these old forks don't just snap. As I said on my last little recording up here, that's been there for years and years. It's a nasty bloody bump. Yeah, you did, you bitch. Yes, I've got my high vis on, but it just doesn't seem to register in some people's brains. Hello. Yeah, blacked out windows, you can't see Albert, can you? Yeah, look at that control. Huh? Tight bend, that. There's a few lorries come down there with the sat-navs on a rather ill-advised sat-nav navigation. What are you looking at? Are you looking at Albert? Hey, he's got a camera on his helmet. Hey. Yeah, if you're up to no good, Albert, you're on film now. Go on, bus fella. I'll have to wait for them cars to come through now. Forecast rain later. don't usually come out on the bike on a Saturday. As I keep saying, Saturday's a fettling day when you do all the little jobs, and Sunday's your traditional biker's day. Now, nice stretch of road, isn't it? A bit bumpy. There's somebody in it. Oh, the sign's back. I thought someone had pinched that. It wasn't there before. Maybe they bring it in over winter. Well, yes, we're here again. Nothing new, because I've been here before. So I'll turn round. No, bollocks to my little dance. If there were nobody here, I was going to put the camera. I brought my spare camera and a little tripod to put on this bench. I'll show you. Yeah, that's a little tripod and a little thing. With grippy, rubbery feet. I've had that for years. I got it years and years ago. From Jessup's, I think. And the feet splay out on little bendy wires. Nice and stable. And my camera is in the inside zip pocket. I hope you can feel it. Zip pocket, there we are. Anyway, I don't need sound because I put a little bit of music on. Anyway, you get the idea, don't you? Just leave that standing, filming. Because of the screen at the back, you can sort of see what you're looking at. Anyway, that's not going to fall over. Well, so much for that. I think I managed to disguise the last part of the dance as that car came round the corner. I disguised it as a jump over a muddy patch at the side of the road. Well, the idea's there anyway. I planted the seed of a new idea. Is it new? No. Planted the seed of a new idea in your imagination. You might be a better dancer than me. Yeah, I think I'll put that extra little light on. Ah, now look. Have they improved this road? They've only done a spray, you know, a spray tarmac down, don't they? Then add the granules, the gravel. But it is an improvement on what it was, a big improvement. And they must have filled all the big holes in. So there we are. All the mornings, you can stop mourning because they've resurfaced it. How long it'll last, I don't know. I suppose winter spiky trees do look nice sometimes, don't they? It's a completely different sort of ride when they're like this all bare. Right, let me get off and push Albert. Is this road open again? I think I'll go up it. If it is, and have a look, see what they've done. Oh, no signs up. So it must be open again. Oh, there's a sign saying Falling Rocks. As you may remember, I walked down here last summer just to have a nosy of why the road had been closed, and all it was this wall here on the right. There's only visible signs of a recent repair. I think it was that section that wasn't green. And there's a bit of loose earth that fell down these little ravines, which you can imagine when it was pissing down really heavy, these will be little roaring waterfalls heading down to the river below. So you can't see that river when it's summer with all the leaves on the trees. But it is quite attractive. Look. Somewhere to turn round. Farmer Giles, out for a walk. This looks new. We're getting higher and higher. Above the valley and the river below. Could have pulled in there. Better with the sun behind me. Should I scare that old farmer with a Tarzan cry? No. This is like a miniature version of Sam Smith's rides on a road a third of the width. Well, it's all open again, ready for summer. At last. Yeah, so it's this section here, can you see? Oh yeah, that's where the repair was. Imagine closing a road just for that, why not put traffic lights up and keep it open? Yeah, that's an idea I had, mate. Bring your camera, take lots of pictures. That's a nice little hill, isn't it? It could be there in the Lake District. Lovely. Lake District is about 60 miles that away. Should I carry on to Kirby Lonsdale via Slade Bin? No, I won't. No date stones. Long Preston 12 miles, Slaverin 1.5 mile, Wannington 5 mile, Clitheroe 6.5, Lancaster 17. And that's it, eat, drink and sleep then. There you are, Hepcat Harley and Mandy, you can get bed and breakfast there, somewhere secure for your bikes. Lancaster's 17 mile off, and Lancaster's a gateway to the Lake District. But as I said before, Morecambe's a good base if you're going to explore the lakes. Cheaper hotels than Blackpool. It's just, have they got somewhere secure for the bikes? There might be a path at the top of that hill, but oh, possibly. I'm not going to do any hiking today, I'll stick to biking. Let's pull over here. Oh, a little gushing waterfall, isn't that nice? Very good. Yeah, that was strange. When it was pissing down, it was last week, I had to go to Morrison's. I run out of milk and stuff and cereal. I thought, well, it's raining, but I'll have to go out. Open the door. I thought, what's that? I thought it was a leaf. And it was a frog or a toad, about that big. And last time, that happened before. There was one in my backyard, and Tommy were petting it. And that was summertime. It was full of dust. So I had a sandwich box inside, a plastic sandwich box. So I took the lid off, coaxed a frog or a toad inside, and took it down to a stream like this, about 2 miles down the road, and let it go. Now I saw my mum, oh, what's the toad doing round here? I said, no need to take it to a stream, some of them live in fields. I said, well, it would have got squashed, so I took it to a stream. Have a little swim and jump on the banking when it wants to stay dry. That's being an animal lover, I couldn't have harmed it. But when I saw that other little frog, I said, I'm sorry, I'm not going down to that stream with you. Turn these lights off. Not gonna sink. Yeah, I should make a habit of bringing my little plastic dish with me. The sheep keep that grass closely trimmed. They'll be thinking I'll stop for a piss, won't they? For the Porsche. Not gonna fall over, is it? I don't think. Is that full of wildlife? Oh, it's a little culvert under the road. How long has that been there? Centuries. Has anyone had a Dewey metal detector? I keep fantasising about the possibilities of buried treasure at these old, undisturbed sites. And someone said, oh, they'll have been done many times. I said, no, not necessarily. I mean, would that have had any kind of maintenance over the centuries? It looks like a pretty old wall. Someone's just found some Saxon gold, an amateur metal detectorist. It was in the paper. 3 gold necklaces, just like new, because of course gold doesn't deteriorate in the ground. And they're worth a bloody fortune. He said he's going to split it with the farmer. And they got some molehills. I could do a little dance here, couldn't I? Yes, I left my keys in. What if a nutcase pinches me back? See, that's a modern addition. Some people do that, don't they? Explore upstreams with the waders on. Is there a pot of gold under there in that culvert? Silly sod. Plenty of sheep shit, little pellets. What do you think? Should I do a dance here? Set the camera up and dance behind my back? Nah, silly sod. Any grot spots? Not too bad, really. rough patch there. That's just with that Jubilee clip. Coolant pipe. Is that bloody? Yeah, it's like that glue run. Oh, it'll peel off. Oh, it has to be. I used Gorilla Glue on the other side, and this side was just Yoo-hoo. I could do with bolstering them before they snap off. I think they're tasteful additions. Doesn't look too silly, does it? Nice Honda wings. Right, I get home, have a nice warm brew. It's not the camera off, just the test, we're still filming. Yes, still filming. And if anything's been done with that pub up here, the jacket's open, it just feels drafty. Nice old country pub, the Moorcock, and it's been shut and derelict and vandalised. Well, I'm on about them, weren't I? Them form things. I've dropped the case now because it was only £2 something. I said, well, if he's denying that he's received them after I sent them back. And being cheap, I didn't even bother with the proof of posting. I just stuck a couple of stamps on, sent them back in the same padded bag to Bolton, and he claims not to have got them. But I was thinking I could get some that sandpaper, sand all this off, and just leave it gleaming alloy. Why bother about blue? I think it's blue enough. No, is it that engine heat? Or is it the actual temperature of today? They say you double it, don't you? Double it and add 30 to get centigrade back to Fahrenheit. So it's slightly out. 15, double that. 30 and 30, 60, and it says 55 Fahrenheit. It works exactly when it's 20 degrees and 70 degrees, you know, double 20, 40, add 30, 70, but it drifts a little when it's not that temperature. Right, nothing coming, let's get out of here. Horizon.